Welcome to Vancouver Carpenter. It's a bit of a weird angle to be filming at. So today I'm going to teach you guys how to coat these weird sort of acute angles. So one of the things you're going to need is one of the... Didn't just drop anything. You're going to need one of these prison shank knives. I will try to link one in the description. Now, if you can't find one of these or you don't have the time, you can also use a margin trowel. I don't know if this is a margin trowel, but a pointy little masonry trowel. Those work well too. That's what I just dropped on the floor. I will do my best to get you guys right up close. That's the closest I can get you. And I'll try not to block the shot. Okay, so I'm using a 4-inch knife here just to get most of the mud in place. So I'm going as close in as I can get, right about like there. And knowing which way the corners of your blade are facing is really important in this case. So I've talked about in my videos that knives will often have a curve on the blade. You want to make sure that you've got the curve facing out so that it doesn't leave lines in your work. It's actually really helpful to have a curve in your blade for this job. So find your curviest 4-inch blade. Next, we gotta put some mud in here. So I'm just gonna scoop a little bit off. If you guys can see, let's try and get a better angle. I'm just gonna scoop a little bit off onto the side like so. And we are going to go right into the corner carefully and just swipe this way. So first, let's make this pretty with this. All right, so I'm going up as far in as I can go and I am wiping that side. I have a little bit of a mess on this side. I'm going to take care of that real quick. And there, take care of that real quick. Now I'm going back to what I was doing. So I'm going to try and smooth it out nicely right there. And right here. So we're going to leave it nice and as smooth and flat as we can get it. But we still have this big lump in here, which is good. That's what we wanted. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna put the knife in, like so. Just get the point right in the corner. You can see I was kind of shaking as I'm trying to, but get the point right in the corner, and then rest the right-hand side of the blade against the other wall, and then just pull like that. So all I was left with was one sort of lift-off line right here, which I'm gonna really carefully get my knife in there and feather out. And now we have a nicely coated acute angle. Okay, as you can see, it's looking pretty darn good. And I didn't worry about that stuff in the corner on the other side. So I'm gonna recommend do this on your first coat because now I have the time to scrape that off and fill in any other defects on my second coat. So it's very important that you do this on your first coat. So that is how to fill one of those acute corners with the prison shank. And yeah. I just want to say a big thanks for watching Vancouver Carpenter. If you've been watching for a while and you haven't subscribed yet, maybe consider it, you know? YouTube is an ecosystem. You're part of it and I'm part of it. And when you do that, you're helping me out. On top of that, I want you to remember, do not smash that like button, feather it. So, sorry for getting all YouTube-y on you guys, but we're building this channel. So, thanks for watching. I'll say so again and leave your Bob Ross comment in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Till the next one.